Hey girls, hey boys. We're gonna make us some crowder peas and a jambalaya. A Tasso jambalaya and a Tasso crowder pea. And Tasso is extra smoky, extra seasoned ham, basically. But it's a Cajun seasoning meat that we use down the bayou. If you can't get Tasso, just use ham and bacon in combination. Smoked ham and smoked bacon. But before I get started, let me tell y'all a story. So I got a Tasso to whack up for the crowder peas. And I'm gonna use these pick sweet crowder peas. These are frozen. I'm gonna put a little bit of Earl in here. Not too much, just a little bit. And put our lovely Tasso in there. Think ham on steroids, because that's what this is. See it? Don't that's pretty. Oh, there's a big piece right there. Whack that up too. Put this in there and go get it started heating up on the stove. Then we're gonna put some Trinity and other shit in here. All right, so we got that going right there. And it's smelling wonderful in here. I mean, absolutely wonderful. We're gonna go ahead and put about 2 cups of Trinity in there. Come out of there. And stir that in. That Trinity be frozen, but that's okay. It tastes just the same, or good enough. So once this is unsweated down for about 10 minutes, go on and add you some water. Enough to cover the beans. They ain't put in yet. And some pepper. No salt yet. We'll salt them after about an hour. But we do want to put some garlic. That's something beans and peas loves, is garlic. They also love salt. There's a little bit of salt. That Tasso has some salt in it, and that'll be okay. Now, I like these fresh frozen crowders better than the dried ones. For y'all who follow my channel, these are actually taste closer to fresh hulled crowder peas. So we got them covered with water. We're gonna bring this to a boil and let them cook for about an hour. Now, crowder peas or a member of the cow pea family. It's they're a fruit, number one. Anything that's in a pod is considered a fruit. You didn't know that. And other members of this family would be field peas, lady cream peas, and crowder peas. I think that's the only three that's in the cow pea family. And they're very good, they're earthy tasting, they taste similar to black eyes, which are not in the cow pea family, and purple hulls. Purple hulls, black eyes, are similar taste, and I prefer the crowders. Okay? These sausages are wonderful. got nice fat content to them, and look at that speck of red pepper up in there. So brown these down in a cast iron skillet or super heavy skillet. remove them, add your Trinity. I'll probably use a good 2 cups heaping. Give it a sweat down time for about 10 minutes. Add your sausage back. Add 2 cups of water. And 1 cup, bring your water to a boil first. Bring the water to a rolling boil, and then add 1 cup of extra long grain rice. Bring it to a second boil, stir it, reduce the heat to simmer, cover the pot for 25 minutes and leave it alone. And I had some leftover chicken from that chicken pintalbo that was fried. I bust it up and put it in there too. The breading came off of it. Ignore the recipe that come on these, because it's fail wrong. Cook them for a good hour. Simmer them for an hour. Stir them. Add your salt. Another 30 minutes. And they'll be done. And we had a little salad there. It is with no salad dressing on it. Cukes and all kind of stuff in there. And this is what your finished meal going to look at you like. See that? Ain't that pretty? And there's your creamy crowd of peas and Tasso. I didn't put the Tasso in the doggone jambalaya. I forgot. Oh well, maybe next time. A fella who's a union communications worker just commented on one of my videos, my union video, and reminded me of a story. And it's a true story. This really happened. I was, a second year apprentice at the trade school, the union trade school. And we had this job at the telephone building downtown in Baton Rouge. And it was a multi-story, one of them high-rise building. I think it was like a 6-story building. So that's probably about 100 foot tall. Well, on the roof of the building, they had some cooling towers with the pumps for the condenser water for the chillers that were down in the basement. And I think we had to change out No, I'm wrong. The pumps were in the basement. The cooling towers was on the roof, and the chillers was in the basement too. Well, one of the pumps had tore up, and we had to replace the pump. But the valves wouldn't hold. They were butterfly valves on a 6-inch line going up to the roof. And in cooling towers, I think these were, it were 2 chillers down there. So they were like 400 ton chillers. So it was like either 6 or 8 inch condenser water line going up to the roof. Well, the valve wouldn't hold a shut off on the butt fly valve. The stem was broke off on the rivets. So it wouldn't shut, it was jam open. So the air conditioner was out, the pump was out. They had temporary air conditioning feeding the telephone building, and this was the central location. This shit down in the basement now, we had to drain the condenser bundles on the chillers. So we had 2 hose pipes going around to this sump pump thing down in there in the basement, and we had to watch we didn't overload the pumps with the water coming out. And my foreman figured it was going to take a good 12 hours to drain that water out that coolant, those 2 cooling towers that was up there. And he said, well, I need a volunteer to work overtime to watch we don't overload the pumps and flood the basement, basically. I said, I'll do it. I need some extra money. Getting ready to get married to my first wife. Need some money for the honeymoon. I said, okay, you it. be down here at 6 p.m. this afternoon. I'm going to show you what to do. So I got there and he said, look, we got everything all hooked up. The hose pipes are running down in the sump pump. Just watch the pump, make sure it doesn't overload, or overheat and burn up. and you don't flood the basement. And everything's set, it's running, it looked like it's doing okay, but you don't never know, a pump may burn up. One of the pumps that was pumping that water out the basement area, the basement sump pump. Y'all know what that is. So I'm sitting up in there, and you know, he already told me, bring your lunch and, you know, whatever you're gonna drink. And I'm sitting down in there, a couple hours went by. This fella showed up in a suit and tie. Hello, can I help you? You know, and he said, yeah, I'm the engineer on the job, and I want to know why I got to pay for you to stay down here and watch this cooling tower drain. These cooling towers drain. I said, that's what my foreman told me to do. That's all I know. Said, watch the pumps, make sure we don't overload these sump pumps, and it's going to take about 12 hours. He said, well, I got to pay your time. We need to get this going faster, this fella said, and he was a mechanical engineer on the job. He said, I don't think we're getting enough air into the system. We can speed this up by letting some air in. I'm like, what you talking about, boy? Well, the condenser, I think these were yard chillers, and the condenser tube bundles were up on top of the chill water bundles on these chillers, and the bundles were probably, I don't know, about 6 foot off the ground on a housekeeping pad. He said, go up on top of that condenser bundle and take that plug out the top to let some air in. Thinking, wait a minute. We got 10,000 gallons of water on a roof in the sumps of those cooling towers with these 6-inch pipes coming down here, and you want to let air in it? Because, oh, I'm an engineer. I know what I'm talking about. I don't know, man. My superintendent, my foreman didn't say none of that. He just said, watch this. And that's what I'm supposed to do. He said, oh, come on. Let's get this over with, and then you can go home, go to bed. Okay, well, if it'll speed it up, we'll see. Now, a six-story building, probably about 100 foot tall. That means with no pressure on open water tower or on that many feet of pipe coming down, you're going to have about 43 PSI of standing head pressure. All right, so I got up there on top of the chiller, and they got a 2-inch pipe plug on the water jacket. So I started turning it off, and I got to about the last thread, and it started skeeting. I said, man, they got some pressure on this. He said, go on, take that plug out of there and let some air in it. I said, no, it got water coming out. There ain't no air in it. I ain't taking this plug out. My superintendent ain't told me to do that. So I started tightening it back. He said, wait a minute, I said, if you want the plug out, you carry your ass up here and take the plug out. I got out off the ladder and walked at a safe distance. This fool got up there, turned that plug out. 2-inch stream of water with about 43 PSI behind it. About knocked his ass off the ladder. It was low overhead in the basement anyway. It hit that ceiling. I mean, wet him, his suit. Knock his glasses off his head. I was sitting back over there laughing my ass off. And all this water coming down in this basement. And now them pumps ain't keeping up. I'm like, oh shit. I walk over to the stairwell. I said, boy, I hope you can get that plug in there. If you can't, I hope you know how to swim. And I start walking up the stairwell. And I heard him over there just, oh, God, man. He finally got the plug back in. Had about a foot of water all over the basement. all kind of electrical switch gear down there. It's funny as shit. So I babysitted the rest of the project, and it finished early because Dum-Dum pulled the plug out and blew most of the water out. And I had to shut the valves off on the hose pipes because the pumps were struggling at that point. My foreman came back up next morning. He said, "Damn, I didn't think you'd be finished just yet. I thought we still had water." And I told him the story. Oh man, he had to sit down on the stairwell. He was busting a gut. He said, and that was whatever the engineer's name was. I said, "Yeah, that's who he said he was." Oh, he was laughing. He was laughing. He loved it. That's a true story. Anyway, they went ahead and changed the pumps, whatever they had to do, because I'd worked a night shift and I was off. By the way, a half-inch pipe with 50 PSI coming out of it, it's hard to hold your finger over that. A two-inch pipe, you better be a bad son bitch to try to stop that water flow at 50 PSI, 45 or whatever. That's a lot of volume, hoss. You're going to get wet big time.